The Bulisa District Education Officer, Chizaka Sangaki, has revealed that out of 100% of girls who join primary school, only 25% make it past primary 7. He says this has been happening for the past 5 years.
Has not been good, right? Because most girls who join P7 don't finish at P7 at 100%. For instance, like last year, I served there in the period of 5 years. Find a given year 100% girls who are enrolled in P1. By the time they finish P7, they are 25%.
Chiza has revealed that they are now putting up bylaws that will help them keep girls in school.
Map the roadmap, action points. We are also coming up with, we have made sure that every sub-county is going to have a bylaw which will be implemented. And we're involved in security, and we shall make sure that we implement it. At district level, equally, PO's office has been beefed up with the staff. Interviews are ongoing.
This was revealed at a function that was held at Bulisa District Headquarters, where Total Energies officially handed over scholarships to 10 girls who are joining secondary. The scholarships were given to students who got first grades in 2022 PLE exams.
86 first grades compared to 2020-21, which was the COVID year, where we scored 37. But this year we scored 86, and we would have scored even better than that, but because of COVID-related concerns and the flooding of the lake, many parents were affected.
Total for this, as Bulisa District, you have been actually performing poorly on the side of girl-child education, simply because of a number of factors, domestic violence, girl-child neglect. There are some traditions, different culture, whereby others still think that a girl shouldn't go to school. A girl must actually be taught domestic work.
You should be the best, basically. 4, 5, 6, but a first grade is also considered. And then the second criteria is, where were you born? You have to be born in Bulisa and Noya. The criteria is, we start with those born in Bulisa and Noya and study in Bulisa and Noya.
The beneficiaries are from both private and government-aided primary schools in the districts. Some of the scholars and parents have commended Total Energies for the support and vowed to work harder.
Scholarships for Noya and Bulisa, targeting the girls. Total Energies discovered that the girl child is quite disadvantaged via education, so we introduced these scholarships in the district. The scholarship started in 2015 for the girls, and we targeted the two districts because we were struggling to get scholars.
And that's when I finished my studies.
While flagging off and handing over school requirements to the scholars, the Bulisa LC5 chairperson thanked the schools for performing well in the recently released exams and tasked the scholars to do their best to excel in their studies.
Thank you, Kilima, Dandamire, Ngwedo, Ngwedo Primary. Surely, we want this picture. And by the way, I have been impressed to learn that Ngwedo Secondary, City Secondary School, had the second best student in O level, last year's O level. Second best student, scored 18 aggregates out of best 8, with about 3 distinctions. So please aim high.
Total Energies Uganda has awarded 20 scholarships to girls who are joining secondary schools in the districts of Noya and Bulisa with all other school requirements. Report compiled by Godfrey Mohomuza for the news.